Hello and welcome to Chemistry in Your Cupboard. I'm Rosie, an Education Coordinator for the Royal Society of Chemistry, and today we're going to make tie-dyed milk. Have you ever wondered how a pond skater can stay so easily at the surface of the water? Water has this kind of invisible skin which allows certain things like pond skaters or a feather to stay at the surface. This experiment relies on breaking down this invisible skin to make patterns in milk. You can try this at home with a responsible adult. So let's get started.
For this experiment, you will need some milk, a shallow dish, washing up liquid, food colouring, a paintbrush or a cotton bud, and a straw. First, I'm going to pour the milk into the dish. If you use a shallow dish, you only need a little bit of milk. I find this experiment works best if you mix a little bit of food colouring with some milk and add it to the dish with a straw. Dip the straw into the coloured milk and keep your finger over the end of the straw. Then release your finger to add the colour to the dish. Try to add the colours carefully and leave a little gap between them so they don't mix up. Watch out, as the food colouring can stain your hands and your clothes. Now I'm going to put some washing up liquid onto my paintbrush. You can use a cotton bud instead, or even your fingers if you don't mind getting messy. I'm going to pop my paintbrush in the middle of the milk and food colouring. Wow! Look how quickly the colours are swirling away from the washing up liquid. Those cool patterns are all thanks to the soap breaking the surface tension of the liquid. Milk is an emulsion of fat in water, and all the water molecules in the milk are strongly attracted to each other. At the surface, there is air above the milk, so the water molecules are not completely surrounded by each other. This makes them even more strongly attracted to each other at the surface, which creates a kind of skin on the liquid. This is known as surface tension. The washing up liquid weakens the forces between the water molecules and breaks the surface tension, causing the food colouring to mix and make the tie-dye milk. Although it may look appealing, please don't drink the soapy milk, it won't taste nice.
So that was the tie-dye milk experiment, which you can do at home with a responsible adult. I use semi-skim milk for my experiment, but how about you try different kinds of milk to see what happens? Do you think all food colouring will work, or is there a particular colour that works best? Let us know how you get on and share your results with us using the hashtag ChemistryInYourCupboard. We'll be back for more experiments soon, but in the meantime, subscribe to our YouTube channel for all the Chemistry in Your Cupboard episodes. See you soon!